How is everyone doing tonight? I am just bumming out that there's so many sick people right now. My son's school is almost ready to close in Traverse City because there's so many sick kids. He's homesick. The littles are sick. Everybody's sick. Spring needs to get here. Like, now. Pronto. Stop with all this sickness. Ugh. Not fun. Well, I hope you guys are feeling good. I hope it's, your hump day went well. That the middle of the week is past us now, and we'll be getting ready for the weekend. So, we are, I'm kind of just on this Bob Ross kick, and I took a look at a challenge that I'd seen. You know, somebody had asked what my first painting looked like, and I just posted that so you guys could see that. If you want to know what I'm doing, I'm just kind of covering this in some white gesso, because we're going to be doing another landscape piece. I just spoke not too long ago to a gallery in Bel Air, Michigan, that's going to be displaying some of my art. We'll put probably 4 or 5 pieces there. I'm pretty excited about that. So I was going to show you guys, this was what started it all. The OG painting here with like the most basic brushes I could have found with my kids about 7 months ago. That's kind of what got me started, and I've just kind of, you know, learned from there. So I'm pretty excited to kind of see where things are going to go. So anyways, yeah, I hopefully will be putting some stuff in a gallery soon, like a legit one, not just a little coffee shop, you know, someplace. I'm actually going to have you know, some legit stuff going on, so pretty excited about that. A lot of good things happened in there. So with that being said, one of the things that they said is they don't really have a whole lot of is landscape pieces like I've been doing, and I really just love that. If you see me look off like really weirdly, it's not because I hear something, it's because my contacts get dried out. Just so you know, I mean, it's not like a super weird tick thing I have, but that's where we're at with that. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get some of this sky going here, and we're just gonna have fun with this piece. It's a really big canvas like the one we had before. I think it's what? This one's even bigger. This one's like a 30 by 20, I think, or some 24 by 30. It's a big piece. It is a big canvas, probably one of the bigger ones. It might even be, take a look, it's huge. It's a big canvas. So yeah, so that's what we're gonna be rocking with. I'll let you guys enjoy the music and enjoy the painting. So I'm sure you guys can see that a little bit here. Okay, there we are. All right, you guys enjoy. All right. Okay. we're gonna just make this sky kind of colorful. Bring all sorts of stuff going on in here. And the good part is we did this on a white pre-gessoed canvas, so it's gonna have maximum blendability to all this. Alright, so we're gonna come right back down in here. We are gonna throw just a hint yellow. One more. Throw in just a hint of red. Little one, come on. Really just want to get most of this covered. Doesn't have to be, especially down here, this is going to be, you know, a reflection. So we're going to straighten these out just a little bit, because in most cases the reflection is going to be a little straighter than what we've seen in the sky, just because it, this is kind of how reflections go. Or at least in my world, as Bob Ross would say. Almost had enough paint. I think we're good. We'll use it all. Use everything we got. Cool. Alright, now I just really want to feather these edges so that we're not leaving anything weird out there. I hate that. You almost get done and you got a weird fiber hair sticking out. Okay. Nice. Cool. All right, so we definitely have some different variances in. We got up there. We got some reflection down here. Super cool. Looking a little pale in there. Cool. All right. Let's switch this up a little bit, shall we? All right, now. I got a little overzealous with my palette knife washing it, and I ended up breaking it, so hoping that it won't be too much of an issue. For making these mountains. So I'm just mixing up whatever we had left of our light blue and kind of our dark blue. Because we're going to have these icy mountains again. Actually, I'm going to do a little bit more. Dark blue. just kind of laying out the mountains where they're going to be. Find my
tired of
plastic palette Amazon knife here because
lets you listen
that
ad
thing
free.
Is going to be kind
try
of
try it now, free for 30 days. Just ask, try Amazon Music Unlimited. Renews automatically, cancel anytime.
Don't have time to sit and read a book? Enjoy Audible audiobooks, whether you're at home, commuting, or in the gym. Just ask, try Audible for free on your device. Free for 30 days. Cancel anytime.
Alright. So,
hey guys, are you ready for
one of the things I did
that won't break the bank,
I didn't do last time
as you covered. With dress shirts crafted from the finest cotton and sweaters in premium cashmere, your wardrobe is sure to thank you. Looking great has never been so affordable. Discover Button Down exclusively at Amazon.
Thank you. Okay, cool. So that gives us kind of our layout of where lights and darks are going to be. So with that being said, time to start getting colorful here. Last one. Need to kind of feather through there. now we do need to do the back side. So we're gonna add a little bit of darker blue to that. And then we're gonna switch up. Nice. This one we got just little hints of this stuff. A little dark in there. The cool part is we can come back through here. We'll adjust that here in a second. Cool. Alright, so we have our mountains. Looking sweet. Fluff this up a little bit. Cool. Nice. There we go. Done with the fluffy duffy mountains. Cool. Alright. We're cool with that. Now going to plate. Okay. Where in the heck did that come from? Must have laid it in some white paint. Whoops. Okay. I laid this one. So put some white paint on it. Alright, so we're just going to use the dry brush and come through on this wet paint. Let's pull some of that through. It looks like a reflection. Set that one in the white paint again. I'm gonna go rinse these off real quick. Thank you. again, so. Just kind of making some bushes along here. Gonna be our front foliage. So same thing we did before, we just pull this along here. There we go, cool. Nice little reflection there. Back in this one black. Just kind of finish out just a little bit of land. And you know what to do from here.
Customers love Amazon Basics for cables and batteries. But did you know Amazon Basics has more to offer? From bedding to light bulbs.
And I don't know why I start in the middle with these trees. I don't start at one end and go to the other. I think because I want it to be a little different as we go through.
Even greater value with Amazon Basics. Discover why our customers love us by making your next purchase with Amazon Basics. Search for Amazon Basics on Amazon. Or visit amazon.com/AmazonBasics.
Hey, guys, are you looking for incredible clothes at an affordable price? At Good Threads, we're obsessed with craftsmanship. From hand-picked fabrics and custom prints to expert tailoring and quality construction, we're on a mission to design super precise fits with all the details you want. Discover exceptionally soft shirts and chinos with a vintage feel. With all products wear-tested, you'll have great-looking pieces that work in real life. Every detail tells a story. Shop Good Threads exclusively at Amazon.
I'm starting to see some progress here. Kind of see where we're at with all this. Thought I'd switch it up a little bit, use a different brush, and I think that one just needs to get rinsed out because it's a little full of paint and kind of clunky. So we'll just finish it out with this one. In there. I like to get these edges kind of full just because you don't want the edge of your painting to have a bunch of question marks of like, what is going on over there? Did you just forget it? Did you not finish it? Is it undone? Just really want those ends to feel complete. At least that's kind of my take on it. So, as much as we can, just want to get that kind of filled in there. Got a couple more little trees here. We'll feel a lot better about it. Finishing out on the bottom. And again, these don't have to be super detailed because they are just reflections in the water, so they're not going to be as crisp as looking at it obviously up here. Bit of clunky edge there with the little dots. I don't like that. That's kind of what ends up happening when the brush starts to separate. You get these weird little separation clunks. Super weird. Thank you. So, a little improvisation there because it started out as the shortest of the trees and kind of moved a little bit higher just because we wanted it to kind of mask some of this stuff in the background. Worked out really well. I guess we really didn't need to worry a whole lot about what this edge line looked like here with making a nice wispiness there, but hey, just want to be make sure you're doing the right thing with all this stuff. Cool. All right, so again, grab that brush, pull down. Give us nice again, like we wanted to talk about on the other side. We don't want to leave it kind of unfinished, so we're going to put a bigger tree up here. And we didn't need a trunk for it because it's just kind of off to the side. Fan brush, just one that's already been washed, gives us a little different texture. It's not kind of used up and full of paint. Almost done. Make this one a little bit sparser, just because it's out towards the edge and you can catch some of that color in there. Add some texture and kind of some life to it. This last tree's got a little bit more open edges. Makes it kind of tie it in nicely. Actually, now that this is drying, this looks kind of funky over here. Kind of see it here, it looks a little funky because we didn't go all the way right down to the water line with some of these trees, so we're gonna want to come in and fill that back in because we don't want that to be kind of like unfinished trees at the bottom. We didn't quite get all the way down in there, so there. That looks a little better. Less green. Very cool. Very cool, very cool. I like it very much. Nice. I love it. Oh, I love it a lot. Now, one thing we have not done yet is some beds. A couple of them up here. Sorry if I'm in your way. These birds don't look super weird. There we are. Couple of birds. They look good. Nice. Time to put on P-Dub. Gentlemen, the six of you we have left, drum roll please, here is our big mountain range Bob Rossi looking thing. I love it. I hope you do too. We definitely got some mountains in there. I think these look like the best mountains we've done. Some birds, we finally put some birds in there. Hey birds, we got plenty of pine trees there. Now we're right in your grill. Alexa, skip. And so we do have some water. We probably could have gotten a lot more water in there had we opened it up a little bit, made those pine trees a little smaller. But you know what? I like the layout of it. I hope you guys do too. Majestic mountains, got some birds, got some trees, foreground, middle ground, background. Yeah! We got some color in the sky, color in the water. There are hints of orange and red and yellow in the water. You do see that. Some of you do. Hey, Mom. Mom, did you see? Here you go. There you go. How about that? Nice, big, majestic mountain range. Got some color in the sky. You see that red kind of mimicked in the water a little bit, if you can see it right down in there. Cool. Very cool. Very cool. I didn't put any white in the water just because I wanted to kind of stay away from that a little bit. I guess we could throw a little bit in there. Do a little bit of it on this foreground just so that it doesn't look all black. on a lot of white there. Just gonna run a little bit here. Those of you still watching, we added a little white just so we can differentiate where those shorelines are at. Little tiny bit of waves towards the middle here, just a little bit. Now last night I kind of overdid it with some and didn't feel like it really looked all that realistic. This time I barely touched it with a little bit of white, really adds some pop, really adds that shoreline definition, and there we are. Much better. Much better, much better, much better. Woohoo, yay, love it. All right, this is a huge piece, guys. This is awesome for a room. I'm gonna go ahead and just paint the edges black. You guys don't need to hang out with me to do that, but love it. I absolutely love this piece. Again, if you look at that compared to the OG here, this is the original mountain range bird cloud piece I did like 7 months ago when I first started. And I think it's a little better now. I'm just being silly. I know it's a lot better now, but I'm still very, very humble in what I've done and what I've worked on and the people I've worked with. So super awesome. I love it. It's awesome. Thank you guys for watching. Really appreciate it. Biggest mountain range piece I've done. I just absolutely love this piece. Yeah, I hope you guys did too. Hope you feel inspired to do it as well. Don't think it's too intimidating. You saw what I first started with, so I'm sure you guys can do better than that. So I love you all. Take care. Have a great night.